Hello. Welcome to New to Who Week on Choreo Chaos. For those of you who don't know, New to Who is a Twitter hashtag used by BBC America promoting viewers to share their first encounters with the television phenomena, Doctor Who. In case you don't have the honor of calling yourself a Whovian, let me break it down for you. We Whovians like to consider this a sport. Allons-y! Doctor Who is a British sci-fi adventure show that originally aired in the 1960s, starring William Hartnell as the enigmatic Doctor. The Doctor, though very human-like in appearance, is not human at all, but rather a Time Lord from the planet Gallifrey. He has two hearts, and instead of dying, he's able to regenerate his body, allowing for, so far, 11 regenerations throughout the history of the show. The Doctor, in his many incarnations, travels throughout time and space in his blue police box, which is actually a time and space ship, called the TARDIS, with his human companions sniffing out trouble no matter where or when they are. My first experience with Doctor Who was actually fairly recent, just about a year ago. Why did it take me so long to declare myself a Whovian? Two words. Gift set. Thanks to the miracle of Tumblr, I was actually able to fake about 98% of my Doctor Who knowledge, largely due to having seen a ton of the show in GIF form on my Tumblr dashboard. After about a year of quiet ignorance, I finally confessed to Katie that I had never actually seen the show. So I was sent off to watch all of the reboot, Doctors 9 through 11, on Netflix. But my curiosity got the best of me, and I ended up not starting at the beginning. The first full episode of Doctor Who that I ever watched was The Doctor's Wife. To this day, Idris, as the TARDIS, is one of my favorite characters. I love everything that comes out of her mouth, and it is certainly my absolute favorite episode. The TARDIS is exactly like the Doctor in so many ways. Terribly old, but still delightfully playful, wise, but still very naive. She shows up and turns everything that the Doctor thinks he knows about the TARDIS on its head. And one of the best lines in the series, if you ask me, are all people like this? So much bigger on the inside. Ugh, and I cry like a child at the end every time. To me, that episode is without a doubt one of the most quintessential episodes in the history of the show. They always tell you to start with blink, but The Doctor's Wife should always be second. Anyway, I watched The Doctor's Wife and decided that I was in love with Eleven and the Pawns, so I watched all of Matt Smith's two seasons before going back to 2005 and Christopher Eccleston. Let me tell you, what a shock. I hope at the end of this week, any of you non-Whovian viewers out there are inspired to give it a go. Sometimes the effects can be kind of cheesy and the villains can be a little silly, but largely Doctor Who is smart and funny and heartbreaking and frightening and so beautiful. It's a show about friendship and bravery, love and sacrifice, and knowing that even a 900-year-old Time Lord doesn't have all the answers. So go check it out, or if you already have, leave us your New to Who stories below. And for those of you who are up to date, enjoy the new season. The ladies of Choreo Chaos will be sharing your laughter and tears and confusion and possible elation with you the whole time. So I'll see you all next time, and Hannah, I will see you on Friday.